Hackography, where tech meets art. The information provided by Hackography is for educational purposes only. We are not liable for any damage or loss incurred from the application of this information. Use discretion and consult a professional if necessary before following any instructions or advice. Viewer and user discretion is advised.
Today we will read the shutter count of this camera, Canon EOS 1100D. And we will be doing this with a tool called Magic Lantern. And this is not an official tool, this is a kind of firmware hack which applies to some of the Canon cameras. So be very careful, because it's very risky and you might break your camera. So don't hold me responsible if you do this. Do it on your own risk. I'm just sharing my experience how I did it. Now, to get the Magic Lantern, you will need to visit their homepage, which is magiclantern.fm, and this is just a landing page, and you have to scroll down and check whether our camera is supported. This is the list of supported cameras what you have here, and as you see, 1100D or Rebel-T3, this is how the camera is called in Americas, is actually supported. Now you scroll down to the bottom, you see here, yes, take me to the downloads, and you have to choose here download nightly builds, and then here you will see different models of the Canon cameras, and you have to choose ours. It's well, 1100D or Rebel-T3. Now be careful here, as you see, one of the software tests has failed. I tried it out, it worked pretty well for me. So yeah, will be pretty risky now. Yeah, we will get there. You have to download the Magic Lantern 90 build, blah blah. It's from 2018. We have right now February of 2019. So not really every nightly, but still you can get it. It will download. It's not very big. Just several megs. It's almost 2 megabytes. So yeah, now you got it. You have to extract the content of this archive, and you will have a folder which has this whole content. You have to copy everything from this extracted folder, copy it, and put it on your memory card, which you will insert then into your camera. Now, this memory card, I recommend to format it, to put it before you do this. Put the memory card in your camera. Go into settings and make a format, low level format of the camera. You will make sure that the camera is clear, or there's enough space, and then you go and copy the content of this folder, which we just extracted, right in the root folder of your memory card. Yeah, now let's put the memory card in your cam like this. Make sure you put it right away. Close the cam. Now let's turn it on. You have to go into settings, into menu, and choose, yeah, you have to choose here the firmware version 1.0.5. Now be careful, because as of now this Magic Lantern hack works only for the firmware 1.0.5. which is not really up-to-date firmware version, because the latest firmware you can get today in February 2018 is the version 1.0.6. Now, if you have some different version other than 1.0.5, just get this 1.0.5 from the Magic Lantern site. They have it there. Once you choose your Rebel-T3 or 1100D model, They will also provide you the firmware which you can install on your camera. Do it in case if it's not, if you don't have 1.0.5. Now I got 1.0.5. I downgraded it actually from the version 1.0.6. So it went pretty well, because you know, with downgrades you have to be careful, extra careful sometimes. Not all the cameras, not all the equipment, you know, out there will allow you to downgrade the firmware. Upgrade, mostly not a problem. Downgrade, not always allowed. In case of Canon cameras, at least with this camera, it was not a problem. I could downgrade. Now, yeah, you are here in the menu again. And you have to choose here that you are agreed to upgrade the firmware. Yeah, you see, it normally it would go to the update. It throw you away from the menu, and now Magic Lantern goes and triggers all the right stuff within your camera to allow to run it. To run my Magic Lantern. Now we are done. Please restart your camera. If you will wait too long, you see the counter here. It will actually uninstall Magic Lantern. We will do it later. So if you want to only read the shutter count with the Magic Lantern and you don't want to keep it, you can later uninstall the Magic Lantern. Now we will turn off the camera, turn it on again. And now if you go normally to the menu here, you will be just in the Canon menu. It's a standard Canon menu here. What we have to do is we have to push this button. It's an AV button or a trash bin button. We will press it and now we go into the menu of Magic Lantern. We will press any button here. And yeah, we are there. This is great. This Magic Lantern thing is really awesome. I used it many times. It makes it just brings your camera on totally another level. But in this case, we won't just only read the shutter count, and we have to go into the debug menu. And then we will navigate to the button here, almost the latest menu item will indicate the total amount of shutter count. Now we have it here. It's a 24K, 24,000 releases of the shutter. And it's split it actually between the standard mode, which is 21,337 plus 2,452. Oh, I just lost. Yeah. We'll go again there. And this 2,452 stays actually for the shutter count in the live view mode. This is the live view mode. Oh, I have the cap on. And yeah, this is like whenever you are taking video, shooting movies, it's the same mode. You can autofocus works really terrible in this mode with this camera, but still sometimes you would need it. Yeah, that's it. Now you know your shutter count. Now you can actually go if you don't want to keep Magic Lantern. Oh, sorry. All the terrible menu items. Now we can actually uninstall it by doing the firmware upgrade. We have to go into the menu. Then we have to choose this firmware menu item. We have to agree here to update the firmware. It again throws us out of the menu settings, and now we have to wait for 1 minute. And after 1 minute, it will just erase all the settings, so that you will be safe to use the camera normally again, as you did before. After you removed the magic lantern settings from your camera, you can actually format the card. By doing so, you will completely remove it even from your memory card, and you will not have it anymore. And there will be no tracks from this firmware hack in your camera. But now afterwards, you know the shutter count. We'll just wait 7 more seconds. See what happens. Yeah. Disabling boot flag. Done. So you don't have this all these flags in your camera anymore. It was completely removed now. Now you can go into normally here into menu and format the card. Choose here low level format as you wish, if you wish it. And that's pretty much it. Now you have a clean camera and you have all the information about the shutter count. Well, so that's it. Thank you very much. Give me a like and subscribe to the channel. See you. Bye bye.
Hackography, where tech meets art.